Hi, my name is Riyad Saeed. I'm an engineer here at Agilent Technologies. Today, what I'd like to do is demonstrate our new digital signal interface module connectivity to the Agilent X series signal generators. This module allows you to stream digital IQ to and from your baseband chipset. We designed this module to enable baseband engineers to verify their ASICs or FPGAs before the RF chain is complete, allowing you to accelerate your baseband verification. Let's go ahead and look at our demo setup. We have the MXG streaming over our digital bus to the digital signal interface module, over the LVDS ribbon into our device under test. Connected to our device is the logic analyzer. We're going to be doing some post-processing analysis. That's for the digital output mode. On the digital input modes, what we're going to be doing is sourcing the data from our DUT over the LVDS link into the DSIM and back into the MXG for RF upconversion. From there, we're going to analyze the signal at the RF using our PXA spectrum analyzer. Here's a block diagram of your device. In this case, we're going to substitute the receiver chain with the MXG and the digital signal interface module to stream the digital IQ directly into your FPGA. Inside your FPGA, you could perform BER analysis, or you can actually look at the decoded bits through your logic analyzer. Let's go ahead and configure this setup. So the first thing we want to do is configure our arbitrary waveform generator to transmit an LTE signal. So we go ahead and turn on the ARB. Next, we want to go to the aux function and turn on the digital interface. Before we do that, we have to set up the logic type, LVDS. Next, we want to do the port configuration. In this case, we're going to do parallel IQ. Next, we want to configure our data setup. In this case, we're going to do 16-bit words. And then we're going to do the 2's complement format. And we're going to have the bit order be LSB. The final step is to configure our clock. In this case, we're going to set our clock rate to 200 megahertz, and we're going to be sourcing the clock from the source into the device under test. Once we do that, we can turn on our digital interface module. Now what we're doing is we're taking digital IQ from the MXG, streaming it over our digital bus into the digital signal interface module into our device under test. The next thing we want to do is look at our logic analyzer and actually visualize what we're transmitting to the DUT. So you can see on the logic analyzer here, we have the binary I and Q channels and our clock coming into the logic analyzer running at the full 200 megahertz per second. Now let's look at the input mode. Here's a block diagram of your device. In this case, we're going to substitute the transmitter of your device with the MXG and the digital signal interface module. This will allow us to verify the RF performance of your digital baseband and make sure it's not creating any spectral splatter or ACPR. Let's go ahead and configure the setup. Since we already set up our digital output mode, setting up digital inputs should be a lot simpler. In this case, all you have to do is go to the data setup and change your direction. In this case, we're going from output to input. Once you've configured that, now we're streaming from the device under test to the digital signal interface module over the digital bus into the MXG. The MXG is then upconverting it. In this case, we set it to 2 gigahertz, and we're going into our spectrum analyzer and doing an ACPR measurement. So you just saw a demonstration of our digital outputs mode and digital inputs mode. In the digital outputs mode, you can take advantage of our full Signal Studio application suite for realistic digital IQ stimulus. In the digital input mode, you can take advantage of our fully calibrated RF chain to do RF verification of your chipset. Both modes offer flexible interfacing to tailor to your specific ASIC. If you'd like to learn more about the Agilent X series, please visit the URL on your screen. Thank you for watching.